Hello and welcome back to your own channel Indian Defense Analysis, where we bring to you all the latest development happening in the defense sector. China has deployed 100 advanced and long-range rocket launchers at its high-altitude borders amid a standoff with India. As per Hong Kong-based South China Post, the People's Liberation Army PLA has deployed over 100 PCL-181 self-propelled howitzers and truck-mounted howitzers to ramp up its defense for winter season. The move has come after Indian Army enhanced its deployment of M777 ultralight howitzers and a regiment of K9 Vajra guns at the Line of Actual Control (LAC). Chinese mouthpiece claims that the range of China's PCL-181 gun is more than double than that of M777. Now question is, how good is PCL-181 self-propelled howitzer? Is it better than M777 howitzer? So in this video, we are going to analyze the same, so let's get started. Talking about the difference between two howitzers, M777 is a towed howitzer and PCL-181 is self-propelled howitzer. PCL-181 is a truck-mounted 155mm self-propelled howitzer used by Chinese People's Liberation Army. The howitzer has 52 caliber cannon with a range over 40 km with conventional projectile and 72 km with rocket-assisted projectile, and also capable of shooting laser-guided and satellite-guided projectiles. Now, M777 howitzer is a towed 155mm artillery piece with a 39 caliber barrel. It has effective range of about 24 to 37 km depending upon the type of ammunition used in the howitzer. However, if M777 combined with M982 exa-caliber GPS-guided munition, it can fire at a range up to 40 km. So Chinese claim about the range of both howitzer is incorrect, as effective fire range will vary with different ammunition, or maybe they have taken in account of the lowest range of M777, that is 24 km. However, no one knows the actual range of PCL-181. Maybe it is overhyped like other Chinese weapons. PCL-181 is equipped with an automatic fire control system. Digitalized control panel can be found in the cab, and this is highly digitalized system allows artillery gun deployment with a press of button, automatic gun calibration and half automatic ammo reload. This can shorten the preparation time to shoot the weapon, giving the artillery stronger combat capability. It can fire 4 to 6 rounds per minute and it requires crew of 6 for operation. Weighing only 25 tons, PCL-181 not only has high mobility, but it can also be transported by large transport aircrafts like domestically made Y-20, which has a cargo capacity of more than 60 tons. A single Y-20 likely carry two PCL-181s or a combination of PCL-181 and 130-ton class Type 15 lightweight main battle tank. Talking about M777, it is fitted with General Dynamics Armament System and Towed Artillery Digitization TAD system. The TAD digital fire control system provides onboard ballistic computation, navigation, pointing and self-location, providing greater accuracy and fast reaction time. It also includes a laser ignition system, electric drives for howitzer transverse and elevation, and a powered projectile rammer. It has a firing rate of 7 rounds per minute and requires a crew of 7 for operation. It has a weight of 46 tons. It can be transported by helicopter, transport aircraft and ship. The howitzer can be towed by an air-braked 4x4 vehicle greater than 25 ton. In summary, PCL-181 is lighter in weight, require less crew and have less firing rate than M777 howitzer. Also, PCL-181 has more firing range than M777 howitzer. However, M777 is a battle-proven platform and being used by Australia, India, Canada, Brazil, Saudi Arabia and USA. On another hand, PCL-181 is only operational with Pakistan and China. So M777 is a trusted choice of many countries and PCL-181 has no battle experience. Also, we have K9 Vajra, which can provide better mobility with firepower. This was today's update. Please let us know what is your view about these in comment section. Feel free to post your comments and suggestions on any topic related to defense sector on which you want to hear from us. With this, I would like to say goodbye and Jai Hind, friends. Please like and subscribe our channel if you have not done already. We will soon back with more interesting and amazing development happening in the defense sector.